first two episodes, someone did die in each one, but I know that moving forward, there won't necessarily be a death every week. Have some shows gotten a little too gung-ho with killing a character promising to kill people as something to attract more people to the show?
I mean, I don't know if I would even say it's a fault of other shows. I think that for our show, though, the thing that's going to make it stand out from the movies is that you actually are having the time to get invested in these characters. And as Jill had, you know, Noah's character saying in the pilot, once you're invested in them and you care about them, when they horribly murdered, it hurts. And that really, I think, like Game of Thrones and other shows that have been doing that.
I was just going to say, really, Game of Thrones has done it, because they don't, like, sometimes they'll kill six characters in one episode, and then they'll go three episodes without killing anyone, and it's really just giving you this world that you care about.
It's a chance for us to have not only those kinds of scares and the terror of it, but actually see the characters processing and dealing with it, you know, in the aftermath. And, you know, that's something that you just don't have the time to do in a slasher movie, you know, very often. And certainly not in the screen movie. It's something that it really helps to sustain the series.
So, any concerns, you know, like in the movie, it has a finite end after 2 hours. Any concerns you would run out of cast if you wanted to
do 5 years? And I'm sure you want to go that long. We'll be bringing in new cast members for sure. We have a phenomenal group of people and actors that we love, which makes it even harder for us when we aren't killing them off. As we said during the panel, they dread seeing our names pop up on their phones because they're afraid it's that phone call, so they never answer it. But,
I mean, we'll find, if we are given the real estate, we will find a way. But yeah, we really fell in love with this cast. The casting process was about 6 months, and it was extensive. I mean, we had a lot of possibilities and a lot of back and forth. And we were so lucky when we did get this cast together, the incredible chemistry between them. They've all been, they're kind of all roommates. A lot of them have sort of, they live in the same building down in Baton Rouge where we're shooting, and they just really bonded and friends. Yeah.
When a movie like Parenthood or TV, you can see, oh yeah, found the story. There's a lot of things that even get through at all because of the thought of losing all the cast.
Well, we definitely had to, that's one of the things, you know, you have to change. Because we've talked about, do you do this show like an anthology show, like American Horror Story? Do you do a different cast every season, or do you take the same cast and put them in a different situation? But for us, we realized that these characters were strong, and, you know, like Twin Peaks, if you have a bigger mystery, if you have a small town that has a lot of secrets and a lot of depth to it, that you've got a lot more to dig into, that you can get, you know, you can do snapshots, you can do sort of a micro look at a family or a character or the ramifications of someone's death. And it's something that, once again, you don't get to do in the movie version. So,
I think that when MTV took a risk on Teen Wolf, and it really worked, they did a great job with it. It really opened up the doors for shows like ours.
You introduced, do you guys know what a killer is?
Oh, yeah.
Do you know when you intend on reviewing?
I do. And yes to both of those things. You can't break a season of a show without knowing it. And, I mean, there's wiggle room because we have tried to very carefully lay it out that it can be anyone. And, you know, luckily when we really kind of got to the end of the season, we looked at it, we were like, wow, we actually really could. And we decided to change it and have it be somebody else, but our plan has so far held well.
How far in advance have you planned? Do you have ideas for if there's a season two, if there's a season three, if there's a season...
If there was a season two, we definitely had a jumping off point and where things could go, and even like the broad stroke ideas of the potential for a season three. And, you know, obviously those are sort of milestones that you know you would you'll
there's
figure
signposts.
Out who's going to be there. There's signposts.
The name of my company is Signpost Up Ahead.
That's right.
So it's like that's kind of how I think about it. It's like season two. You know, when I went in to pitch to MTV, like once they were happy with the pilot, and then I had to go in and sort of pitch what would season two be, what would season three be. It's like. Obviously, I don't have the whole thing figured out, but when you throw out enough tantalizing tidbits and they realize, oh, that's all planned, that's all set up, and you're like, yeah.
You can make it work. There's actually there is enough material here to explore that will be different enough too. And that's part of the fun, I think, of the show. When you're paying homage to the genre, so you can actually lean more into different kinds of the horror genre within the Scream sort of mythology and tone, which is nice.
You've introduced the trivia.
You guys plan to have any celebrity guest stars, mainly from past films, at all in the future, just out of curiosity,
you know,
or any involvement with them?
We have talked about it, and I think now that we've premiered and a number of them responded, I mean, Courtney Cox was lovely, and there she was tweeting about it to us, and
Drew
Barrymore and Jamie Kennedy, I mean, so a number of them, they embraced it, which was really very flattering for us. I think if we could do it, and it was... It made sense for the character, and it wasn't going to distract from the experience for our core viewership of this world, because it is very separate from Woodsboro in terms of mythology and characters and backstories. I think it would be a lot of fun to do. I'm certainly not opposed to it.
Never seen it. Yeah.
You've introduced the trivia. Is that voice going to be consistent now, or are you going to play with a new voice box?
The whole idea of this killer and the big theme of this story is the masks that we all wear. You know, the idea of on social media you can be anything you want. And that was a really fun idea to introduce to our killer. And, you know, we are going to bring him into 2015. And so he might have different ways of presenting himself, like in the second episode. Calls as, you know, the guy who's from the security company. And so it's finding fun ways to put people off their guard or gain their instant trust, you know. For me, it's like, just because someone's dressed like a policeman, they're not a policeman, you know.
So this is a follow-up to my original question about who the killer is. Does the killer know that they're the killer?
In terms of the actor in the show?
Or actress.
Or actor, actress. We have made people aware of what they need to know when they need to know it. Because you have to be a little careful with certain things. Because if you tell somebody here's a piece of information and they internalize that, they may not even know that subconsciously they're starting to project it. So you have to kind of be careful with when you want to reveal certain things to them.
And it's amazing the fear and worry among some actors who will read a scene and they're like, I'm the killer.
No,
not necessarily. It might just be a ruse. And they'll call and be like, that's my killer scene, right? I'm totally the killer. And it's like, calm down. Just relax.
Well, I mean, the whole idea of everybody has secrets and lies. And, you know, if you peel back the curtain on any family or person in town, that's what you're going to discover. And that's what we're unmasking.
Yeah.